家好，欢迎收听这一期的早安英文，我是卡拉。
And I'm Joseph.
今天要来帮助大家区分几组长得非常像的英文单词。 You may sometimes be confused by them. 比如说我印象非常深，初中的时候啊，关于这个 quiet 和Quiet. I took a lot of time to tell them apart.
Oh, really? For you, you had the problem with quiet and quite. I have a problem with my students with three words. Quit, Q-U-I-T, quiet, Q-U-I-E-T, and then quite, Q-U-I-T-E. So these three words, I think, are easy to see the difference, but today we're going to have more words like this to help you guys understand which one is which.
要不我还是以防万一给大家解释一下吧。 Quit 是放弃的意思，就是 give up、然后呢 Q-U-I-E-T 是这个
安静
啊，对，安静安静。然后呢 Q-U-I-T-E 是这个 quiet， 相当于 very、有的时候可以相当于 very。 那我们首先要讲的第一组呢，就是前阵子我不是长了很多的 acne， 长了很多痘痘，然后呢我就查了一些 acne treatments, acne solutions, 然后我看到说要忌口， it says you should avoid some certain kinds of food, 比如说 dairy products. I was like, what? Diary 不是日记吗？
No, dairy, you know, D-A-I-R-Y, dairy means from milk or from a cow,、and, you know, diary, because diary starts with D-I as in die, and、dairy starts with D-A-I as in day.
但是这两个词真的长得太像了，因为它们的字母是一模一样的，然后中间的 A 和 I 调换了一下顺序，当然发音也不同了。刚刚说了 D-A-I-R-Y 牛奶的或者奶制的，然后、它读成 dairy， 然后 D-A-I-R-Y 是日记读成 diary。 第二组呢是有一次这个 Neil 老师在彩蛋里面自己讲过自己黑历史，让我想起来这个天使 Angel 和角度观点叫做 angle，但是其实这一组我觉得 we can tell them apart by their pronunciations.
We can also tell them apart by the way they're written.
I know you're going to say that.
Yeah, Angel, A-N-G-E-L, has the ending G-E-L,、which is pronounced gel, so angel. And angle, G-L-E, many other words ending in L-E, just make a l sound as an angle, angle.、
而且比如说这个 Angela 就是 Angel 然后再加一个 A 来的嘛，所以天使这个词是以 L 结尾的。然后接下来九老师来一组吧。
Aboard and abroad. If you know board and you know broad and you put the in front of them, I'm sure you can see that it's almost the same, but board means to get on something. So aboard means to get on something, and broad means wide, so abroad would be far away. Again, just look at the letter after the consonant. B-O, board, B-R, broad.
就是大家可以根据这个发音来区分，主要看这个 consonant, 就是这个辅音后面的那个元音。A-B-O-A-R-D, 它是 aboard, aboard.表示上飞机啊或者上船啊等等这种意思，而 abroad 就是 A-B-R-O-A-D， 它表示在国外。
Alright, I can give you two sentences to help you understand in English. As for aboard, he was already aboard the plane. And then as for abroad, she worked abroad for a year.
大家如果实在分不清，确实也可以根据记例句来区分他们的意思。第一个就是他已经登上飞机了，再一个第二个句子What is that again? The second sentence?
She worked abroad for a year.
就是她在国外工作了一年的时间。
Now for the next one, it would be two words that have similar meanings, but not the same meaning, but they definitely look different to me. And、this is the word principal, P-R-I-N-C-I-P-A-L, or P-R-I-N-C-I-P-L-E. Both sound like principal. The way when we're children to help you remember is...Principal ends in P-A-L, which is a person, the principal of a school.
就是校长。
And then principal, P-L-E, like angle, yeah, is also a noun, but this one means like a rule or a belief or, you know, morals and virtues, this kind of idea.
它的中文意思呢，就是比如说原则、准则或者原理、定律这种意思。
Right, and since the first principle ends in P-A-L, which is pal, so we can remember that's a person, it can also be an adjective, and this time when it is an adjective, now it means important or main, like a principal idea.
就是说这个 AL 结尾的 principal 它也可以做形容词来用，这个时候呢它就相当于the most important 或者 main 主要的或者最重要的。嗯，给大家造几个句子来帮助区分一下。首先呢，比如说我们平时经常会讲说，哎呀，这个人真的是没有一点原则，英文可以说成 He's got no principles at all。 或者呢，给大家一个对比更加强烈的句子，我们说这个校长真是一点原则都没有，你可以讲 The principal has no principles。
Okay, I see what you did there. The first one is P-A-L, principal, because it's a person. And the second one is P-L-E, principal, because it's the idea.
大家要好好捋一捋啊，不要搞混淆了。
The next one, I guess these two words could look similar, would be stuff, S-T-U-F-F, and staff, S-T-A-F-F.
对。
Right, and so staff, S-T-A-F-F, can mean workers that are employed in one place, the staff of a job, the staff of an organization.
要注意是这个 all the workers, so they're considered as a group.
Right.
我们中文里面这个语法里面会管它叫做单行复义，还叫做全体员工、全体职员。所以如果它做主语的话 ，the staff were very good. 这个谓语动词要用复数形式。
Another meaning for the word staff would be like a stick, something you use to walk with. Maybe an old person would have this.
拐杖。
And so our other word is stuff.Stuff just means things, but we usually use it to mean things. It actually can mean substances or materials.
嗯，就物质啊，或者材料啊，东西啊，都可以用这个。
Another meaning for stuff is a verb, which means to shove things into something, like stuff your mouth when you're very hungry.
就是把什么什么东西给塞满，拼命的往里面塞东西。
And the last one that I'm thinking of would be economic and economical.
Economic 和 economical 它区别就是economical 后面要多一个 al.
Right, and so economic is the adjective coming from economy.
嗯
And economical is the adjective for not expensive.
其实大家仔细想一想，我们中文讲经济的，我们可以其实有两种不同的理解。第一种就是 economy 的形容词，和经济和财政有关的，比如说 social, economic, and political issues, 就是社会的、经济的、政治的问题。那第二种呢，其实经济的你还可以理解成经济实惠的、节约型的，比如说 an economical car, 就经济型汽车、节油型汽车。
Right, you could say it's more economical to use gas than coal.
Really? 好的，感谢大家收听我们今天的节目。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢，是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
That's what I was told. I don't know much about it.
好了好了，那我们今天的节目呢，就和大家聊到这里了。这一些单词大家一定要区分清楚了。Oh, sorry, 我是卡拉。
And I'm Joseph.
我们下期再见吧，拜拜。
Bye.